This is what we discussed. What is analysis mean? What is singly reinforced means? What a rectangular beam means? Because rectangular is the cross section of the beam. Beam will have a length, width, and depth. So this cross section is the small b is the width of the beam. Capital D is the overall depth of the beam. Beginning from top to the bottom is called the overall depth of the beam. And this is cross section of the beam. Right? Now you have in the cross section, remember these rods are placed on the entire length. I showed you long time back how the things looks like. One second. If you way back here, you are able to see the slide. Reinforcement yes, along with the reinforcement. So this is the span of the beam. One second, I'll put in a laser pointer mode. So this is the span of the beam or length of the beam from here to here. This is a span. Okay, and this is the width of the beam. This is the depth of the beam. These are the main reinforcement. What are main reinforcement? These four. Usually in a singly reinforced section, you will not have four rods at the top, but this is only the schematic diagram. So here there is a, you can forget about these two. Only let us assume that only these two are there. This is called hanger bar and this is called stirrups. This is called stirrups. So if you see, if you look at this figure from here, if you look at this figure from this side view, that is called cross section. You have width of the beam is this much, and this is the depth of the beam. And you have a stirrups, and you have, these are all mainstay. And if you look at this one in the front elevation, front side, this is your length. Okay, this is the total length of the beam. This all these four reinforcements are represented by a single line here, because when you look at this one, only one rod will be visible because all the rods are placed parallelly with each other. When you look at it, you will see only one rod. All other three rods are behind this first bar, so only one rod will be visible. Similarly, this is the top bar, and these are the stirrups. Stirrups are placed at a particular specific interval. Okay, so here this is the distance, this is the spacing. That's and all here space. Okay, so this I already discussed. So now we will begin with our discussion here. Okay. So this is the area of tensile steel. This is the area of tensile steel. Area means you find out the area of one rod and multiply. If suppose if all these bars are same diameter, then number of rods multiplied by the cross section of one area will give you area of tensile steel. Remember, area of tensile steel is represented by A suffix ST. A S T. Okay. Now, if you take the centroid of this is the centroid of this main bar. Now, the distance between the topmost compression fiber and the centroid of the steel is called small d, which is called the effective depth of the beam. Okay. Now, in the first type of problem, we can see type one. Data given are here, so I'll just zoom it. You're able to see the screen. Hello. Hello. Are you able to see?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So,
yes, sir.
In the type one problem, you have a data given as. You have cross sectional dimension. Cross sectional dimension B will be given, D will be given, or small d will be given. In some form they will give. Area of steel provided will be given to you. And grade of concrete used, whether it is M10, M20, M30, or M40, whatever the grade of concrete will be given. And grade of steel also will be given, whether it is a Fe250 or Fe415 or Fe500. Likewise, you will be given. And then your moment, what is the bending moment or the load they will give to find out the bending moment. Okay, Now, in the type 1 problem, what they will ask you is what is the bending stress developed in the beam, and whether the for the given this moment, given this section, whether the section will be cracked or not cracked. That is the question they will be asking. Now, you should know if this kind of question comes, bending stress is evaluated using simple bending equation only. So we have to use service load. As I mentioned in my earlier lecture, you have two types of loads. One is called service load or characteristic load or working load. These are all same. Service load, working load or characteristic load. So bending stress is calculated only for service load or characteristic load or working load. Similarly, the type of section is also decided based on finding out the moment due to service load only. We are not going to use design load or limit load or factored load. Okay, so this is the thing you have to be very careful about. We are going to use only service loads for finding out bending stress in the beam, as well as whether the section is going to get cracked or not cracked. Okay, so this is the type 1 beam, type 1 problem, analysis problem. Okay, now we will go through one of the problem. You will understand much better. So this is our analysis problem. In analysis problem, you will, in the slide you will always have this downward arrow with analysis and problem number 1. Okay, if you have any doubt so far, please ask. As soon as there is a doubt, please ask. Okay, don't wait for me to finish and then ask. Wait for me to ask, is there any doubt? If you have doubt, immediately raise the question. Okay, now this is the problem that we are going to see. This is the first problem. A beam of size 300 mm by 600 mm is reinforced with three numbers of 25 millimeter diameter bars at an effective cover of 55 millimeters. The grade of concrete and steel respectively are M25 and Fe415. So concrete grade is M25, steel grade is Fe415. Full stop. The beam is subjected to a bending moment of 50 kilonewton meters. Okay, now what you have to find is whether the section is cracked or not cracked, because you have this section 300 by 600 mm size, and in that tensile steel is given, three number of 25 mm diameter bar is given. So, and the bending moment in the beam is 50 kilonewton meters. Now for this, whether the section is cracked or not cracked, and what is the bending stresses in the extreme fibers? Okay, now all of you, you have to note down three things here. Now they may give you beam of size as 300 by 550 mm. If they give a beam of size, the beam of effective size 300 by 550, then 300 will be the width. This 600 is the, is it overall depth or effective depth here? Here, let us say for this problem, a beam of size 300 by 600 mm is given. Now, this 600 is the overall depth or effective depth?
Overall depth.
Yes. Unless specifically mentioned here, a beam of effective size 300 mm by 600 mm, then this 600 will become an effective depth. Is that clear? First thing you should note down that whether the given size is a effective depth or overall depth. Okay, that's good. All of you are understanding. That is very nice. Now here it is reinforced with three numbers of 25 mm diameter bars at an effective cover of 55 millimeter. What is effective cover? I am not asking effective depth. It is an effective cover.
P, sir.
The distance between tensile zone and centroid of the steel reinforcement.
Yeah, that is effective cover. That also we've seen in our earlier classes. For example, I will just refer it once again. I will show it to you. What is effective depth and all? Okay, here is It's very much before. So effective cover, you may not be able to see. Okay. Oh, sir. You are able to see effective cover. It is the vertical clear distance between the bottommost fiber and tensile zone and the centroid of the steel. Here, the distance between this and the centroid of the steel is called effective cover here. Okay. So now that is effective cover. So effective cover 55 mm scale. So that is one. Now grade of concrete and steel, be pay very careful attention. M25 and Fe415. Now third one to be noted is the beam is subjected to a bending moment of 50 kN/m. Whether the given bending moment is bending moment due to service load or bending moment due to design load. What is given here? If nothing is mentioned, if it is plainly written, the beam is subjected to a bending moment of 50 kN/m means it is a service. The bending moment is due to service load, or bending moment due to characteristic load, or bending moment due to working load only. If you have to mention other way, they will tell the beam is subjected to a factored bending moment of 50 kN/m. Or design bending moment of 50 kN/m, like that they will mention. Okay. Now here nothing is mentioned. The beam is subjected to a bending moment of 50 kN/m. That means this bending moment is due to service load. Is that clear? Anybody having any doubt? So if you not, we will go ahead. So this is the given question. As I told you, this is a design subject. Analysis also the design and there's a. You have to write everything. You have to draw the figure. You have to write down everything in a step by step manner. Okay, as I am going to show you now. So now step one is the given data. As usual, you write down all the given data. So this is a rectangular beam. We know beam of size is given. So size width is given as 300 mm is given. Okay, this width is given 300 mm. And the overall depth is given as 600 mm. This is the cross section of the beam. Okay, right now. It is reinforced with three number of 25 mm diameter bar. So this is a three number of 25 mm diameter bars. So total depth is 600 mm, and this effective cover is how much? This effective cover is 55 mm. So what will be the effective depth? 600 minus 55, that is 545. Any doubt? Okay. So I am writing here. B is 300 mm, overall depth is 600 mm, and FCK means nothing but the characteristic compressive strength of concrete for M25 is 25 MPa, and characteristics strength of steel Fe415 means Fy is equal to 415 MPa. M is given as 50 kN/m and change it to Newton millimeter because these are all Newton per millimeter square. MPa is also, this is also Newton per millimeter square. These are on millimeters. So bending moment M is equal to 50 kN/m is changed to 50 × 10^6 Newton millimeter. Now, is there any doubt in this particular place? Anybody have any doubt? Please ask. Because if you understand this given data properly, rest of the thing is very easy. Anybody having any doubt? So this distance from here to at the bottom, that is called D dash effective cover. Effective cover is mentioned by D dash, or you can use something else also, no problem. But let us say, because sometime you also have a cover to the compression steel also. Let us so total is 600 minus this 55, this distance, vertical distance from the central. That become 545, that is a effective. Okay. So any doubt to this one in writing the given data? Vijay Kumar, are you there? Vijay Kumar Chaudhary.
Sir, no doubt, sir.
Vijay Kumar Chaudhary.
Yes, sir. No doubt.
Okay, good. So now, first of all, we have to find out whether it's a cracked section or uncracked section. That is the first question asked. Okay. First question asked whether the section is cracked or uncracked. That is step two. We are going to find out. Now, how to find this out? You know, given moment is there, 50 kilonewton meter. So cracking moment is equal. If you want to develop crack in this beam, the cracking moment you have to first find out. This cracking moment is given in your code. I will show you the code where it is given. You come to page number 88, 87 is the other one. In 88, annexure C is the calculus of deflection. In that, there is called MCR. This is a cracking moment here. Cracking moment. Are you all able to see this PDF file? Cracking moment. Cracking moment equal to FCR into moment of inertia of grass section divided by YT, where FCR is the modulus of rupture of concrete, IGR is the moment of inertia of a grass section about the central axis neglecting the reinforcement, YT is the distance from the central axis of cross section neglecting the reinforcement to the extreme fiber in tension. Okay, so now you see here M is equal to moment under service load. M is the moment under service load only. So this is what the cracking moment. We are going to find out cracking moment using this formula. Now what is this FCR? FCR is the modulus of rupture, modulus of rupture of concrete, which is also given in your code in somewhere
0.7 into root of 0.7.
Yeah, which I told you yesterday, and it is there also in the given code in the 6.6.2 or something like that. You can see this. Okay, here Young's modulus of concrete and six point something. Here.
6.2.2
flexural strength FCR or modulus of rupture. This is also called modulus of rupture. Is equal to 0.7 times root FCK. Remember, this FCK has to be in MPa or Newton per millimeter square. Then only you can use this formula. Okay. So tensile strength of concrete, or otherwise it's called modulus of rupture or flexural strength, which is called FCR is equal to 0.7 times root FCK. Remember, this is an empirical equation. This FCK has to be in Newton per millimeter square, which is given here. Okay. So cracking moment MCR is equal to FCR multiplied by moment of inertia of this beam cross section divided by the half distance, this height. Okay. That is the distance of extreme fiber from the centroid of the section. So you know FCR is equal to 0.7 root FCK. What is the value of FCK? Characteristic compressive strength of concrete or grade of concrete, which is given as M25. So 0.7 into root 25 is 3.5 MPa. That is your FCR value, right? Now, moment of inertia, this is a rectangle. So you will take one, it is because it's called IG. G means grass section, not effective section. IG is a grass section. So you have to take entire B into capital D cube by 12. That is I grass. And YT is D by 2. This whichever has a cube term, half of that, D by 2. That is 300 down. Now, since all these values are from FCR is equal to FCR is 3.5, IG is 5.4 into 10 power 9 divided by YT in this 300 mm. So you are getting 63 into 10 power 6 Newton millimeters, 63 kilonewton meters. So if you want to crack this beam for this dimension, your cracking moment should be 63 kilonewton meter. What is the moment given here? What is the applied moment given? Bending moment?
50 kilonewton.
Now tell me, your beam will crack or not crack?
It will crack, sir.
It will crack. See, this is not resist. I am not talking about this is a resistance. This is the bending moment due to applied load. I am not telling that this is the moment of resistance. This is the moment that is applied. This is the, if you want to break the, if you want to crack the structure, you have to have a 63 kilonewton meter. This is the moment required for cracking the structure is 63 kilonewton meter. But the moment applied is 50 kilonewton meter. Will it crack or not?
No, sir.
No, sir. No.
It will not crack because your applied moment is only 50 kilonewton meter. And if you want to crack this beam, you need to have a 63 kilonewton meter at least. Then only it will get cracked. So since your applied moment is less than 63 kilonewton meter, the section is uncracked. Any doubt in this? Remember, the beam is subjected to, you read the sentence very carefully. The beam is subjected to bending moment of 50 kilonewton means this is a applied moment due to applied load. This is not the strength. If the beam has a bending moment capacity of 50 kilonewton meter and the cracking moment is 63, means then not, then also here this is also this MCR is nothing but moment required to develop crack in the structure. Is that clear? So since the applied moment is less than cracking moment, section is uncracked. Okay, that is the answer to the first part of the question. If there is any question, please ask, any doubt. Okay, so that is the first part of the question. Now second is bending stress. Remember, we are going to find out bending stress using the simple bending equation which you have studied in SM1. Okay, so bending stress, third is bending stress. Now what is the bending stress equation? You know, M by I is equal to F by Y, or sigma by Y is equal to E by R. Now we are going to focus only on this because we need only this bending stress sigma, right? And we are not worried about this curvature and all this thing. So from this equation, you can write bending stress sigma is equal to M divided by I into Y. From these two equations, you can write sigma is equal to M into Y divided by I. What is the M value given? M is the applied moment, that is 50 into 10 power 6. I value we found out from the earlier 5.4 into 10 power 9. Y is capital D by 2, that is 300 mm. So 2.77 MPa. So your bending stress, so for this cross section, if I take a pen, so for a rectangular cross section, now if you take that, this is the neutral axis, this is the bending stress. This is a linear line. So this is 2.77 MPa. This also 2.77 MPa. The beam is not given whether it is cantilever or simply supported. So let us say if this is a simply supported beam, obviously compression will, this will be the compression stress, sigma compression will be 2.77 MPa, this will be tensile stress, sigma T will be 2.77 MPa, and this depth is 300 mm, this also 300 mm, okay, with this 250 mm or 300 mm. So this is your bending stress, right? So bending stress at extreme fiber is 2.77 MPa, this also 2.77 MPa. Okay, now tell me, is there any doubt, anybody?
Sir?
Any doubt?
Sir, and for a rectangular section, we take a moment of inertia is small b into capital U cube by 12, sir. But why should we take small b into small d cube by 12 in the case 4. So why should we take small b into cap small d cube by 12? Means effective depth, sir.
So here what we are seeing is that in the earlier, if you see, this bending equation here, m by I into sigma by y, this is valid only for if you see the assumptions made in a simple bending equation, you are assuming that the material is linear and elastic, obeys Hooke's law, right? So that you are going to load this concrete only up to elastic limit. Up to elastic limit means there is no cracking in the concrete at all. This concrete is fully effective in taking care of the external load. This entire section is ready to take the load. That is why we are taking I is equal to B into capital D cube by 12. But whereas in terms of if it is a cracked section, then we cannot use this formula itself because your material is not anymore elastic. Because it is a bending equation, is an elastic equation, linear elastic equation, where you are following Hooke's law, stress is proportional to strain. So the material is considered to be inelastic, and so consequently, because you are considering is elastic, there is no crack at all developed anywhere in the structure. So we are taking entire structure is safe to take care of the external load. That is why we are taking b d cube by 12, capital D cube by 12. Is that clear? But there is no such equation as b d cube by 12. Okay, it is not there. Okay, once it is cracked, your concrete is only this much concrete is there. Below that, there is no concrete. Okay, so that is the point. Okay, so that is the answer to the first question. So what was the modulus of rupture? 0.7 root FCK, right? So 0.7 into root 25, which is 3.5 MPa. So here also you can see this is called tensile strength of concrete. So here tensile stress is how much? 2.77 only. But what is the tensile strength of concrete? 3.5 MPa. So your concrete, at this point, it can resist 3.5 MPa. And because your stress is only 2.77 MPa, this will not get cracked. This way also you can check. Is that clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So because this is called tensile strength also. Tensile strength or flexural strength, tensile strength. Okay. So this is the first question. Now, second type of problem. Again, I am taking small b, capital D. These are all cross section of the beam. And these are the area of tensile steel. And this is the effective cover. If you see, this is effective cover. This is the effective cover. This is the effective depth here. Type 2. Your cross-sectional dimension is given, just like B and D, or small d or capital D is given. Effective depth or overall depth is given. Area of steel is given. Grade of concrete and steel is given. What is the concrete grade, M25 or whatever, and steel grade is given. What is asked is find out the type of section. In this type of section means whether it's under reinforced section or it's balanced section or it's over reinforced section, and find out the ultimate moment of resistance of this beam. What is the moment it can resist, and what is the load that can be safely applied on this beam? This is the kind of question that can be asked. That is type 2. Okay, so here this analysis problem, again problem number 2. So now in this problem, I'm going to tell the first step. You have to find out ultimate moment of resistance of the beam. Now how to find out ultimate moment of resistance? Because we have already studied what is balanced section is, what is under reinforced section is, what is over reinforced section is. Everything we studied detail yesterday. Now, so how proceed? What is the step forward for finding out this? This is a step here. So let us say these are the steps. First step is you will find. Yes.
So the first problem, same dimensions for this rest of the sum, sir, means to find the ultimate strength for these also.
I'm not sure. I have to. No. This is not second problem. I'm not started. I'm only telling the steps first.
Okay, sir.
First, you have to find out what is the limiting or the critical depth of neutral axis, that is XU max or XU limit. This you already know from page number 70 of your code. If you turn to your page number 70, XU limit by D or XU max by D is given for three different grade of steel, 0.53, 0.48 and 0.46 value. So you can find out XU max value. Then you will, next one, you will find out the XU value using, you know that from a compression force equal tensile force, force equilibrium equation, in annexure G 1.1a, XU by D is equal to 0.87FYAST divided by 0.36FCKBD. That value, that equation is there. Using that, you can find out what is the value of XU. Now you have XU, we have XU max. So suppose if XU is less than XU max, which is what type of section is that is? If XU is less than XU max, what type of section is that? Mr. Iswar. Iswar, are you there? 41. I guess if I am not wrong, roll number 41 is there. 41 not there. Soumya is there. Soumya? Please unmute and speak.
Yes.
Who is it? Soumya, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If XU is less than XU max, what type of section is this? Under reinforced or over reinforced? Yesterday we discussed in detail.
Under reinforced.
Okay, good. If XU is less than XU max, it is under reinforced. In under reinforced section, which will attain failure first, yielding? Whether steel will fail first or concrete will fail first in under reinforced section? Initial failure will happen by because of steel or because of concrete?
Steel.
I am asking Soumya, somebody else is answering. Okay then. Okay, so you can mute, all of you mute.
Yes,
so,
sir.
If XU is less than XU max, it's an under reinforced section. And in under reinforced section, steel will yield. So, if XU is more than XU max, you have a over reinforced section. So if you have XU is less than XU max, under reinforced section, for that moment of resistance formula is given 0.87 Fy. Because in under reinforced section, your stress in the steel will be 0.87 Fy. Okay. So that is why you are using this equation, 0.87 Fy, AST D into 1 minus Fy into AST divided by FCKBD, which is given in G 1.1b in page number 96 of your code. You can see that. Suppose if XU coming out to be more than XU max, then we will actually, in this case, moment of resistance will be more than MU limit, but we will not go beyond MU limit. So you just find out what is the MU limit is. MU limit also we know, okay. If XU coming out to be more than XU max, it is an over reinforced section. So you will find out mu r is equal to mu limit itself, but actual value will be more than mu limit, but we are reducing to only mu limit only. This we will discuss later on when we get there. Okay, so you will find out mu r either using this equation or using this equation. That is the third step. And finally, once you know moment of resistance, you can find out what is the load acting on the structure. Okay, so first step is to find out XU max. Then you find out XU, then compare these two values. If XU is less than XU max under reinforced section, then you have this equation as a moment of resistance, ultimate moment of resistance. If XU is greater than XU max, you have a over reinforced section. And that case, your moment of ultimate moment of resistance is equal to limiting moment of resistance itself. And from this value, you can find out what is the load acting on the safe load that can be acting on the structure. So this is the step that we are going to follow. Now, let us say this is the problem that is given. A beam of size 300 mm by 600 mm is reinforced at an effective cover of 55 mm. The grade of concrete and steel respectively are 27.5 and Fe415. Determine whether the section is under reinforced or over reinforced for AST. AST means area of tensile steel. Suppose if the area of steel provided is 1200 millimeter square, what is whether the section is under reinforced or over reinforced? If it is provided with 2000 millimeter square, whether it is under reinforced or over reinforced? Similarly, there are four area of steel is given. These are all four different problems, but given in one go. Is that clear? Any doubt in understanding this particular given problem? Beam size is same, and these reinforcements are at an effective cover of 55 mm is given. The grade of concrete and steel is given M27.5, Fe415. Now determine whether the section is under reinforced or over reinforced for AST. This, and this. Okay. So now, first, as usual, write down all the given data. So width is 300 mm, overall depth is 600 mm, and this is the cross section of the beam. Now this is AST. This AST in one case 1200, another case 2000, another case 2960, another case 4200. Now B is given, small b is 300, capital D is 600. FCK is 27.5 because your grade of concrete is M27.5. Remember, M is the mix. 27.5 is the compressive strength of concrete at the age of 28 days curing. So FCK is 27.5 Newton per millimeter square, or 27.5 MPa. And Fy is, Fe415 means yield strength of steel, or characteristic strength of steel is Fe415, is a 415 MPa. Okay. Now, this one you can find the depth of critical lintel, because you are going to find out whether it is whether under reinforced or over reinforced. First you find out as we saw in the previous slide, you find out the critical neutral axis depth, that is XC max. So I am going to ask some particular person to answer. Mr. Aravind, are you there? Aravind?
Sir.
Okay. Now, what is the given grade of steel? What is the given grade of steel? Aravind, I am asking you. Are you there or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What is the grade of steel given?
27.5.
That is grade of steel. Grade of concrete?
Fe415, sir.
Fe415 is the grade of?
Steel.
Steel, okay. Now, for Fe415 grade of steel, what is the value of XC max by D? From page number 70, you tell me. You go to page number 70 of IS 456. What is the value of XC max by D will be given, written there. XC max by D for Fe415, what is the value? Very good. So from page number 70, right? For Fe415 steel, because Fe415 is given. Yeah. So first you are calculating the effective depth, because effective depth is equal to overall depth minus effective cover. That is, overall depth is 600 mm, it is given here, minus effective cover is given 55 mm. So D minus effective cover is 545 mm, which is marked here 545 mm. Okay. So 600 is the original cover, original depth, overall depth, 55 is the effective cover here. So original depth or overall depth minus effective cover will be the effective depth, which is shown here, effective depth. Now, for FE415, from page number 70 of IS 456-2000, XE max or XE limit is equal to 0.48. I have taken D on the other side because I know D here 545. So what is the XE max depth? 0.48 × 545, 261.6 millimeter. Right? Okay, you can mute yourself, Mr. Arvind. Thank you. You are able to tell, but don't get confused about grade of steel and concrete. Okay, now is there any doubt in finding out this value, XE limit? Anybody? If anybody has any doubt, please ask. So from page number 70, XE limit by D or XE max by D is 0.48. I have taken D on the other side. So 0.48 D. Remember, this D is a small D, effective depth. Don't put 600 mm overall depth. This D is a effective depth. That's why effective depth was calculated first, right? Or you write this equation first, then calculate effective depth D. So D minus effective, this one is 545. So 0.48 × 545, 261.6. So this is the second.
Sir?
Yes. Yes.
Sir, the value of steel for XU max by D is 0.48, sir.
XU max, XU limit, both are one and same.
No, sir. XU limit by D is equals to 0.48. So why are you taking again D to that side?
Here I am writing only XU limit. Here I am writing only XU limit, not XU limit by D. Right? It is simple, no? XU limit by, one second. XU max by D is equal to 0.48. I am taking this D this side, that's all. There is no D here, okay? Is that understood? Tanusha is asking, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. XE limit by D is 0.48. I am taking D on the other side, that's all, to find out what is XE limit, right?
Yes,
okay. Okay, now next step is to find out the actual depth of neutral line. So XE limit is equal to 261.6, I found out. Now second, now next third step is to find the depth of actual neutral line, that is XU, and the type of section. Because if I compare XU and XE limit, I can find out whether it's under reinforced or over reinforced. So now to find the depth of actual neutral axis, XU, you know from Annexure G 1.1A, page number 96 of IS4. As I am telling, please refer to the code. If you have the code, that is why I am telling you, you should have a physical copy, hard copy of the code, so that it is very easy to flip over and see. But if you are everything you are doing in a computer or phone itself, it will be very difficult for you. So if you have not already got the code, hard copy, please get it yourself. So from G1.1A, page number 96 of IS456, you know XU by D is equal to 0.87 FYAST divided by 0.36 FCK BD, right? So I can cancel this D and D because I don't want D here. I would just want to find out only D, XU. So I can cancel this D and this D. So XU is equal to 0.87 FYAST divided by 0.36 FCK. Somebody has unmuted, unmuted, please mute yourself. One of you, unless you have a question to ask. Okay, so X is 0.87 FYAST divided by 0.36 FCK into B. Now, in this FY is given. So in this one, XU we are going to find out. FY is given. AST value, four different values are given. And FCK is given as concrete grade is given. B also given, width of the beam is given. So I'm going to do it in a tabular form. Till now, is there any doubt to anybody? Is there any doubt to anybody? If you have doubt, please ask. Okay, otherwise I am going with. So first, my AST is 1200. Now if substitute in that formula, please one of you work it out. You take your calculator and work it out, because otherwise you will not understand. So you know x is equal to 0.87, fy is given as 415, ast is 1200, divided by 0.36, fck is given as 27.5, and b is given as 300 mm. Okay, so you can cancel, this is 4. Okay, easily you can cancel. So remaining you can calculate. 0.87 into
145.87 millimeters.
Okay, so I have taken it as 145.9 XU. Okay, what was the XU max we calculated from the previous slide? 261.6. Now you compare these two. XU is less than XU max or more than XU max?
Less than XU.
So when XU is less than XU max, type of section is
under reinforced.
Is that clear? So because your x is less than x max, it is an under reinforced section. So likewise you can put for other AST. Let us say instead of 1200, if you have 2000, right, what you have to do, you don't have to do anything else. 145.87, this is for value of 1200, then what is the value for 2000? It will be more, right? Because this this is for as the value of AST increases, your XU will increase. So for 1200 it is 145.87. For 2000, how much you can easily find out. You can easily find out. Okay, so what is the value you are getting?
243.13, sir.
Okay, that's what you are showing here. Okay, for 243.1. So 243.1 is less than 261.67. again, it is a under reinforced section. Now third one, if the AST is 2960, then XU will come out to be 359.8. Here I will write XU is less than XU max. Here also XU is less than XU max. What about here? XU is greater than XU max, so over reinforced. Is that clear, everyone? Similarly, obviously for 2960 itself it is over reinforced. Obviously for 4200 also it is going to be over reinforced section. Okay, so this is the, sometime this kind of question is asked, find out whether the section in a gate also they will ask this kind of question, whether the section is over reinforced or under reinforced. Okay, so this is the answer to the second question. Now interestingly, you have another method to find out whether it is under reinforced or over reinforced. I will quickly tell method 2. Remember, we have discussed about limiting percentage of steel, PT, right? So either you do this way, find out XU limit, find out XU, and compare XU and XU limit, then you come to a decision whether it is under reinforced or over reinforced based on the whether it is XU is less than max or greater than XU max. Accordingly, you are defining here. Now, say method 2 is you find out AST limit. How will you find out AST limit? You know PT limit, which equation I already given to you, 41.38 into FCK divided by FY into XE limit by D. Right? Now, in this, you know all these values. How we know all these values? 41.38. We'll take the laser pointer. Okay, 41.38 is a constant. FCK is given as 27.5, that is 27.5. FY is 415. XE limit by D for Fe415 steel, how much? XE limit by D, 0.48, that is 0.48. So now if you multiply all this thing, you are getting 1.316%. Remember, whatever value you are getting is a percentage. So 1.316% is there. Now you know PT limit is nothing but 100 AST limit by VD. So from this, you know PT limit is 1.316%. B, you know, D, you know, 100, you know, you can find out AST limit. So AST limit is equal to PT limit multiplied by VD divided by 100, that is this. So PT limit is 1.316% divided by 100, B is 3 and lambda given in your problem. Small d that you have calculated effective depth is 545 mm. So AST limit is 2151 millimeter square. Okay. So if you want the balance section, the amount of AST to be provided, amount of steel to be provided is 2151 millimeter square. Okay. Now if AST is less than AST limit, it is an under reinforced section. If AST is greater than AST limit, it is over reinforced section. Okay. Now you can see here AST is 1200, AST limit is 2151. So AST is less than AST limit, so it's an under reinforced section. Similarly, 2000 is also less than 2151, so under reinforced section. 2960 is more than 2151, over reinforced section. 4200 is more than 2151, again it's an over reinforced section, right? So we will stop this for this class and tomorrow we will continue. Now let me know if there is any doubt so far. Whatever we have discussed, two problems. Is there any doubt, anybody? But I'm telling you again, please go back and work it out yourself. Simply looking at the problem, you will feel that you understood everything. But when you go back and close your book or notebook or the material close and you try to do it yourself, you will not know which step comes from first, which step will come next. So that is why I'm telling you, you should practice yourself. Because it is an online class, I have to do all these things. Otherwise, I would not have done all this stuff. I will ask you to find out all these things. But because it's an online class, I have to do this. Otherwise, I cannot teach you properly. And besides, some people will get more interested if we give each and every step properly. So they will feel very confident to understand the subject. Okay. So now, if there is any